David, can you give me any background in terms of what went into this speech and what they hoped they could achieve here other than tone?
The president has been speaking about the speech with visitors for at least the last 3-4 weeks. He was talking about the ideas he wanted to raise. I think you can go back to his very first day in office. The first thing he did in the Oval Office was to call President Mubarak, call President Abbas, call Olmert and say, I'm serious about peace in the Middle East. First interview he gave was to Al Arabiya, an Arabic TV station. Goes to Turkey, gives a big speech there. I mean, I think that he is really geared up to do something of enormous importance, and this speech was another road sign, a milestone along the way. We're still in the rhetorical stage, and each new speech, each new interview raises expectations in the Arab world that this man is really serious. He means it. He's going to solve the problem that's haunted us for a generation, and pretty quickly he's going to have to deliver in terms of something specific, an actual freeze on Israeli settlements, which would be a real turnaround for Netanyahu, some other fairly decisive move. Otherwise, I think people are going to say, you know what, this is wonderful talk, but we're in exactly the same place, really, that we've been for 40 years.
They're looking for deeds, and they're saying the Arab world is, we need to see specific kinds of actions that show you have, Mr. President, the political will to take this beyond rhetoric.
Well, to show, Charlie, what's different, this week, as an exercise in writing a column for the Washington Post, went back over the history of U.S. statements about Israeli settlements going back to 1968. Every president over that time, 9 different presidents have said pretty much the same thing. Israeli settlements are an obstacle to peace. We oppose any expansion of them. And every time, the Israelis have continued building them. Is Obama going to repeat that history of strong American statements and no decisive action? That's the question, I think, that Arabs are going to be asking tonight as they listen. Every home in the Arab world is going to listen to this speech tonight, and they'll ask, is it different? Does he mean it?